With the moon in the third house, you have a really strong connection with communication and you have quite an active imagination. So unless the moon is like very, it's got some really hard aspects to it, then you should be quite a good communicator. You probably are very interested in learning a lot of different things. You probably absorb a lot of information quite easily. You might be a bit of an information junkie. And you're prone to being quite curious and constantly wanting to feed, you know, that hunger through kind of learning, whether it's through reading, through things you see on the internet, watching videos, you know. So it's always kind of wanting to expand your mind. You're likely to be a good writer. You might find that you can, you know, that you create really nice poetry. You might find that you just like writing a diary in your spare time just as a natural outlet to let your emotions out. And that might be a really healthy thing to do for you. There might also be some talent in as far as languages go. And with imitating people, you might be kind of good with your voice. You could also be a natural kind of really good and emotionally, connecting singer. You might be somebody who, when they sing, people really just feel, you know, what you're singing about. You might also have, because it's the house of brothers and sisters and siblings, so there could be strong ties to brothers and sisters, or there could be a lot of communication with them. There could be a lot of activity around your brothers and sisters. And because the moon is, it's wherever it is, it tends to make the matters of that house fluctuate a bit. So it could be that relationships with your brother, with your siblings are, you know, they go through phases. They go through a lot of changes. Also, as well as this, you will be somebody who gets bored easily. So you'll probably enjoy moving around a lot in your local area. You'll probably like taking trips out to the beach or to the forests or wherever it is that's like not too far away. So it's not too far from your local environment, but it still allows you to get a change of scene. You'll probably enjoy doing that. And that's probably a really good thing for you to do. You might find yourself traveling in order to learn more and to learn more about different cultures. And that would be a really good thing for you. It would really kind of, you'd really absorb it very well. In terms of, let's say, kind of maybe more negative aspects of this, there is a tendency, because like I said, wherever the moon is, that house, the matters of it can fluctuate. So there might be a tendency for your opinions, because the moon, your emotions are very tied in with your opinions and your thoughts. So there might be a tendency for your thoughts and your opinions on matters to change a lot and to fluctuate a lot. People might know you as not really having a solid opinion on something. You know, one minute you've got this idea, the next you've got that idea. And so that's maybe just something to watch out for, but it's probably something you enjoy doing anyway. You enjoy keeping an open mind, and there's nothing wrong with that because it means you're always able to learn. But just be aware that perhaps people might want to know sometimes where they stand with you better, and if your opinion is constantly shifting, then it may just make it tough for them to know. Other than that, there could be just a little bit too much time spent worrying about matters that don't really in the long run matter. So just be aware of that, because like I said, the way you think is very tied into your emotions. So it's just wise to keep a check on your thoughts and make sure that you're not allowing them to run away with you, especially if it's in a negative sense, and just try and guard against worrying too much, and try and put that energy into productive things, whether it's learning a new language or writing and being expressive in that sense. You know, that's also where you might find yourself doing well in terms of a vocation. Another job that would be suited as well would probably be anything in the area of being a psychologist or psychoanalyst, because that really, really feeds your mind. You love the idea of exploring the psyche of people.